Good evening. My name is Dr. Teresa Carboy, principal at Royersford Elementary School. So this evening, we are here and we are excited to present to you the meaning of Career Day at Royersford Elementary School and how it truly impacts students, even at the elementary level. So Career Day focused on inviting different people from a variety of fields to highlight their chosen careers, but also the skill set involved in achieving that position. Career Day not only inspires our students, but it also creates an awareness of self through interests and abilities. So here is a glimpse of Career Day at Royersford Elementary School.
On May 7th, Royersford Elementary held Career Day. We met different people who showed us what they do every day. This was helpful to me and my classmates to guide us on the right path.
This is gonna be the best day of my
Because when it soaks into wood, there's something called a hyperchlorate in bleach. It's like a really salty stuff.
Outside my window, I feel it in my soul. So the stars were burning so bright, the sun was out till midnight. I say we lose control.
Our minds are warmed up, our minds are focused, we're ready to train and learn. So, boys and girls, are we coming to Chariot? Yeah! Nice and tall, in Chariot position is the start of your focus.
Thank you. At this time, I'd like to introduce Mrs. Brzezinski, our RamQuest teacher, but Mrs. Brzezinski also works very closely with our students to ensure that we spark their interest and help them become future-ready learners through various activities. Mrs. Brzezinski.
Thank you, Dr. Carboy. In helping to meet Act 339 requirements, RamQuest teachers have conducted some surveys with the students. The Interest Profiler Survey was completed online at pacareerzone.org, in which interests were related to the work world. This helps students see what kinds of jobs they may want to explore based upon their interests. Following a lengthy group project, third and fourth grade students were asked to complete a Likert scale, which that's what you can see on the screen up there. This required them to think about themselves based upon their performance as a team member, bringing attention to teamwork and the four C's, which is communication, collaboration, critical thinking, and creativity. This helps students make a connection between their interests and the skills needed to be successful in preparing for a career. And now we have some fourth graders with us today who will introduce themselves and the results of their interest survey. Okay, the interest survey was taken online again, and this is the paper that they had to fill out based upon their survey. Okay, and we're starting with?
My name is Tommy Ricci. My top three career suggestions were medical scientist, allergist and immunist, and finally, physical medicine and rehabilitation physician. I'm most interested in becoming a medical scientist.
My name is Seth Maddox. My top three career suggestions were police, security manager, and government official. I am most interested in becoming an officer of the law.
Thank you. Next.
Hi, my name is Piper Cornegie. My top three suggestions were architects, except landscape and novel, landscape architects, poets, lyricists, and creative writer. I am most interested in becoming a landscape architect.
Very good. Next.
My name is Emmy Smith. My top three career suggestions were medical scientist, astronomer, and political scientist. I am most interested in becoming an astronomer.
Thank you.
My name is Simon Savage. My top three career suggestions were zoologist and wildlife biologist, hydrologist, and soil and plant scientist. I am most interested in becoming a zoologist and wildlife biologist.
My name is Stephen Ferrari. My top three suggestions were a pilot, a Taekwondo master, and a sports store owner. But I am most interested in becoming a pilot.
Thank you very much, boys and girls, for being with us. And now Dr. Carway has some questions to ask you.
Really easy questions. So really, when we have activities in our schools, we always think about how does it affect students? What is the positive? What's the takeaway for kids? So we wanted to ask them some questions so you can see and get to know what did they walk away with. So we'll start with Tommy. Tommy, based on the interest profiler, a medical scientist was your top choice. What is the education required, and what did you discover about the average salary for medical scientists?
In order to become a medical scientist, I would need to go to grad school and get a PhD. Also, my average salary would be $110,210.
Excellent.
Great job. Thanks, Tommy. Seth, what did you learn on Career Day that will be important to you as an adult?
On Career Day, I learned that firefighters save lives at the jaws of life. I would like to volunteer as a firefighter when I grow up, so I will need to know how to use the tools to save lives.
Fantastic. Thank you, Seth. Piper, what is your big takeaway from Career Day?
I became more interested in becoming a pharmaceutical scientist. This interested me because we got to experiment and learn how medications are made.
Emmy, you said you wanted to become an astronomer on your survey. What are some skills you are learning on a daily basis in school that will help you be successful as an astronomer?
Astronomers need to be able to collaborate with others on their team. We also learn math and science each day, and astronomers have a knowledge of both.
Fantastic. I love that you said collaboration. We certainly need to know and be able to collaborate no matter what career we have. And next we have Simon. Simon, as you were sitting in the presentations, are there any qualities that the presenters had that were important to their careers?
Engineers must be problem solvers to see potential solutions, and they must be focused to be safe and accurate in their job.
Fantastic. Stephen, tell us why you think Career Day is valuable in our school.
Career Day is valuable because children can learn about different jobs they think they might want to do in the future. For example, I saw a pilot, a sports store owner, and a Taekwondo master, and they all have different abilities and skills to share with kids. But they all showed us how they are committed to their career. But no matter what career we choose, it is important to communicate clearly and remain committed.
Great. Piper, do you have any further comments?
School board members and administrators, we heard that you've also taken the Career Day survey. Could you please share with us what the survey revealed about your top career choice and how you feel about your results?
If there's anyone that did take it, and if not, maybe you could share with us. I know we gave you a short period of time, but maybe you could share with us, are there any careers or other careers that you're interested in?
Go ahead. I did it.
Thank you.
But I think it's really wrong. So I don't think it worked for me. I think I should retake it.
Okay.
But it did. It was interesting to do it. I haven't done one in a long time, so I love seeing them do it because I guess you guys, was that your first one that you've ever done?
Mm-hmm.
So it is kind of like, oh wow, you know, I might like this or I might like that. I got clergy member, and that's
too late.
I think that's a little bit off, but it is far. I have 5 children at home. I think it's a little far off, but I think that the piece behind it was the social and the I do have one of those bleeding hearts, so
yeah.
That might have fallen into mm-hmm. that a little bit, and that's why it came out. I also got mediator, guidance counselor, so it's all kind of in those. But my top was clergy, so.
That's fantastic, and we appreciate you sharing. And that's what we try to really emphasize with the students. It doesn't necessarily mean this is what you need to be when you get older, when you grow up. But what it does do is spark an interest on possibilities based on their strengths and their interests. So thank you for sharing.
I would be more than happy to share my
Mrs. Spletzer.
My favorite career. I did not have time to take the survey, but that's because I have a very busy job and 4 kids, and I volunteer a lot for the school. But I am a tax accountant, and I love it. I work for a big company, and I help them plan strategies to save money on taxes. It's very exciting. It is.
Sounds
for
it.
For some people.
I took the survey, and I was an engineer, and it said I should be science or engineering, so it was right on. And then it also said I would be good at something creative, which I took a lot of classes in, but didn't pursue that. So that's definitely an interest.
That's fantastic. Yeah, thank you so much for sharing. Is there anyone else that wanted to comment or share? We're okay?
Well, I think... What's important also is that I spent 25 plus years in one career, retired from that, and ended up buying a business and started a whole second career. So that as you go through your life, just because you start in one direction doesn't mean you're gonna end up, you know. So always keep your eyes open and be excited about what will be out in front of you, because you could start off as like a tax accountant mm-hmm. and it's such an exciting career. But seriously, I mean, it's good that the kids are doing this. They get exposure to a lot of different careers, different opportunities, and as they go through their time here at Springford, I think that they'll be exposed to even more different type of careers and opportunities, and I think that they'll be amazed to see what opportunities exist for them when they leave here. So, but it's a great job.
Yeah, it's fantastic to see our elementary students becoming career aware or the potentials that they have as they go through their school career. So I think Tommy has one more message for us.
We hope that you will consider being one of our presenters next year. Thank you.
Yes, please do. We always look for presenters, so sign up if you're interested. We would love to hear about what you do for your career.